Right, welcome back. We need to find a silver dollar.
We do. It's funny, I was thinking about what you mentioned about in the last episode about how humanity actually maybe deserves to die. For me, that was The Last of Us. By the end of the GAT game, I was like, you know what? I think it's good that we're not curing this plague, because humanity definitely deserves to die.
I like that.
That game was grim.
I like that Joel, like your character in that game, was kind of a piece of shit. And like,
yep.
You sympathize with his choice at the end,
but all
people
in that character is
yeah.
There are no good people in that
story.
Well,
Ellie.
The Last of Us are horrible.
Ellie was pretty cool.
Yeah, Ellie. But
other than that, yeah. All right, what do you got?
Yeah, I've got a couple of old Susan B. Anthony silver dollars in my coin collection. They're pretty expensive. I guess I do owe you something.
So there you go. It all comes back full circle. That first thing we did the first day, we've gotten paid for it.
Yay!
With the thing we need to end the game. So, you know, it all ties up. Neat little bundle. So let's go give her the token.
Looks like everything tied up in a neat little bow.
No,
let's go in our space car.
Sorry if it sounded sarcastic.
I miss The Simpsons.
Well, it's still on.
I miss The Simpsons.
What are you gonna go with?
Casually positive?
Yeah, let's just get this done. I'm
tired
of dying.
But I think it'll work. I don't know. Seeing Margot Kidder shoot you was kind of fun.
Several times.
Okay. Go knock on that door and say Jax or better. The man you need to see is in there.
I walked down a hall.
Good job. You earned your paycheck.
On the door, Barrel Puff must be a charming guy.
Sure.
I call out the
yeah, that's an ugly name.
A grating voice calls loudly for me to come in.
Jax or better.
As I step into the back room, I'm blasted by an aromatic wave of cigar smoke, alcohol, fish, and body sweat.
Lovely.
The combination almost knocks me out. The room is empty except
it's
for
gonna be like the Comic-Con later this year.
Seems to be the source of all the foul odors.
I love this.
Or probably WrestleMania when I'm there.
So apparently this is a pure human because he's part of the cult.
Okay. Yeah, you're the epitome of genetics.
He's an example of the greatness to which humanity can achieve. What are we going with?
Friendly, sort of.
My friends call me Tex. You can call me Mr. Murphy, unless you'd like to be my friend.
Are you hitting on me?
No, I made a bet that you wasn't stupid enough to use your real name.
Oh.
I guess we both lose, Murphy.
Well.
You know.
Oh.
Mr. Puss.
I thought he was just going to shoot. Well, it was going to be game over.
It's also illegal to point a Lester flame rod at a total stranger.
Oh, you're not a total stranger. I've been waiting for you for a while now. Though I thought you was going to come up with that chameleon.
So you're disappointed the chameleon isn't here, huh? Why? Was he your girlfriend?
Hell, I ought to blow your head off right now. But I ain't going.
It's
I
working.
Like watching you sweat.
Yeah,
you
know, true enough.
You do. Probably
this guy does seem to have the mentality of a high school bully.
Watch your mouth, boy, or I'll blow your damn head off.
He just totally rags it to this guy.
My boss told me that when you got here, I should take care of you. Now sit down.
Let me get you a glass of wine.
I'd like a Mai Tai with two umbrellas and a nice plate of those cocktail weenies.
I don't think so.
Apparently Burger King has hot dogs now.
But there ain't no sport in that. So I'm
kind of curious.
Get a chance to beat the odds.
Yeah. If you want to go out and buy hot dogs, you got to go to Costco.
Well,
it's the best place.
I've beaten a few odds in my time.
They're cheap and they're big.
I'll guarantee you haven't beaten this.
Oh, God.
Is this...
this friggin' shell game. Which is super fun when the graphics are stodgy as hell.
Why doesn't he just shoot us?
This is more
you're
fun.
A terrible villain.
I call it the Farolette table. Three of them balls are hollow, and there's a spy drone in each one. They're little robotic arachnids with nasty stingers.
There's one thing worse than spiders is robot spiders.
Yeah.
Inside that one is part of a ticket to the Moonchild. I'll mix them around. Then you just have to pick the ball with the ticket and open it up. Do that four times, and I'll take you to the Moonchild.
I don't understand why he's giving us this opportunity when he could just murder us.
It's a video game.
But narrative dissonance. No.
I think he's just playing with us. Like, it's more fun for him, for us to, oh, God.
He's like, I'm bored. All I get to do is sit here and smoke in this room all day. Oh, shit. Are we supposed to be paying more attention?
Yeah.
You know which ball it is?
Yeah, I think so. But just to be careful, I'm going to save. Because sometimes it gets really dodgy.
Man, you can totally just save scum your way through this, can't you?
You can't. Well, it's a 90s game. I believe it was this one. Nope.
Nope. Not
it.
All right. Hi. It's kind of cute. Aw, he barely got out of there. Oh.
Finish up this lousy shell game and let's get on with it.
Yeah. So let's try that again.
I really liked the look on his face when that thing jumped on his cheek. He's just like...
When the thing that wasn't there jumped on his cheek.
Yeah, it was like look of mild concern.
All right, so let's try this again.
Okay, that one. Okay.
Okay, pick a ball.
But except it's wrong. Like, the animation is wonky. Because I definitely followed that ball, but it wasn't right.
Oh, you sure?
Yeah.
Oh, shit, I just lost it.
Yeah, I still have it, but it's wrong. I think it's going to be this one. Yeah.
Beginner's luck. Let's see how you do this time.
If I remember correctly from the last time, it's... Yeah, this is...
I want to say middle one.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's this one, yeah. And I believe it's the bottom twice in a row. It's never the one on the left. That one I remember.
Damn it! I guess I need to speed up the balls a little bit. Well, third time's the charm. For me.
For me? good comeback. Good burn. Oh, God.
Yeah, they do that.
Yeah, this animation does completely screw you up, doesn't it? Maybe save after this?
Yeah, I'm going to. I believe it is the bottom one, but just because we don't want to do this 15 times.
Just nothing makes a good LP like repeating the same task over and over again for a long time. Yep.
Lucky today, aren't we? I can't wait to see a spy drone tear your head off. No one's gotten this far before, Murphy.
Question, if I open the spy drone one and he kills me, what happens to you? Because don't you have a loose spy drone?
He probably has a way to turn him off.
Okay.
Then they do this weird spinny thing.
Oh, God. Yeah, I think it is the bottom.
I believe it is the bottom, but I'm just going to say
that. I think I actually kept track of that one. And it's only the 20-second save.
Yep, not too bad. Hey, we got it.
Yay! Let's play this animation again.
Damn you, Murphy! Old
games, right?
But we did make a deal. I'm taking a few people up to the Moonchild in a couple of hours. You can go with us. I have some business to take care of. Wait at the bar until we leave. Drinks are on
me. Even buying us drinks?
Be sure to ask for the house.
This is a really incompetent bad guy.
Sit down, brother. Have a drink. It's on the house.
Yeah, agreeable. Let's take a drink. I hope it's not poison.
So when we leave,
I'm playing too much Hitman. There's poison in everything.
Now the purification will be tomorrow at midnight.
Yay! Ready for fun?
Yeah, it sounds like fun. By the way, Farrell told me to ask about the house special.
Oh really? Well, Farrell's always been partial to the house special. There you go.
Invite to join in.
This ought to hit the spot. Are you gonna join me?
Oh, no, it's a little strong for me. It's a man's drink.
But you're Margot Kidder. You can probably handle way more alcohol than this dude.
Yeah, probably.
So, you're Tex Murphy. Well, we're gonna make your trip...
That wasn't suspicious.
...comfortable as possible. Nighty night.
So, is it possible not to drink?
No.
Oh no.
And we're down.
That was a pretty fun animation. It's like, okay, you gotta pretend to pass out. You've only got this little amount of space to do it in. So you know, make
do. Well, he's the director. So yeah, he's directing himself. Day 6: Mooning the Cult.
Butts.
Butts are funny. Wait, what? How old are we?
I don't know. I forgot.
The figure was tall and gaunt.
I should have done this before every day. Bearing of the stranger, instead of the last few. Wit
nor propriety. Well, they did it right at the beginning. Yeah, I don't know why they...
There are chords in the hearts of the most reckless.
This is one of Edgar Allan Poe's best stories, too. Mask of the Red Death.
I haven't really read much Poe. Life and death, I have difficulty with older stories.
Yeah, this is a short one. This is only a few pages, but it's pretty great.
I must have died and gone to heaven.
If I could get just like all of his books on tape read by James Earl Jones.
Oh, I think that'd be brilliant. Must be on the moon. I have to look that up. Maybe it exists.
I have to admit, it is incredible. I could get used to living in a place
that's
like
no
this.
Moon.
I've never seen
anything so beautiful.
It's
shut
a
up. Ruined it! Fuck you, Damien. Oh, hey! It's
another floating
these theory. Are so dumb.
I know. But so I totally dumb. Want these to be a thing in like 30 years.
Yeah, absolutely.
Wake up, Mr. Murphy. We'll have no sleeping through the greatest event in the history of the world. I'm so glad you could join us on this sacred day.
It's our man in chair.
You don't recognize me.
Apparently it's someone Tex knows.
Yes.
Lowell Percival, at your service.
Oh, okay, so old game reference.
Yeah, basically it's the guy you worked for in the previous game.
Tenacity, both then and now, have shown me that you belong here. In fact, I need to thank you for securing the statuette for us. A flawless crystal.
Oh yeah, we still got the chip. Did they find the chip?
Are the foundation we'll see.
Of our beliefs. Our sacred text has said that our destiny would be secure only if we had the statuette in our possession. We are deeply in your debt.
You need crazy people and their sacred texts.
An hour or so, yeah.
We will fulfill ancient prophecy. Specifically, the purification by means of the Great Alluvium. It is a fabulous name for a somewhat nasty process. Those creative minds at GRS worked extra hard for a long time to make our prophecy a reality. It was quite a challenge to come up with a plan that would match the details of the Great Alluvium as it is described in our sacred text. Cost me a fortune.
You know, if you make a prophecy physically happen, then does that still count?
Yeah, that's always been a weird thing about...
Like can you force a prophecy?
Yeah, like... I don't know, man. The earth has become a rotting shell. Feels like you're
sort of cheating.
Yeah. It's not fair.
The pure races with their filthy, mutated genes. Here's our Trump speech.
Is that to be the fate of mankind? The earth must be thoroughly cleansed for mankind to be saved. Soon, we'll release the seeds of purification.
Gross.
The Great Alluvium. The baptism of fire, which follows, will destroy all life on Earth. But from the ashes will arise.
I like how this went from "Hey, retrieve the statue" to "I guess everyone's gonna die on Earth."
Yep.
Real escalation here.
Yes.
On the Moon Child. Then our genetically pure children will return to a world that, like them, is clean.
And then they can get to work on ruining everything again.
Yep.
I will die peacefully, knowing that I have given mankind a purified world.
And then we'll build a wall.
I designed this moon child.
Oh, the people will find some reason to hate people. That's all. They never, never.
It's also a splendid place to spend the next 40 years. We have it all here. Aquariums.
Yep, because human beings will still hate
forest, river,
that's kind of a big part of our experience.
Everything you could. Why would you want to bomb her space?
See, the main villains of Naruto had it right.
They were
just gonna put the entire world under a big illusion so they just live in a daydream world that was perfect.
Isn't that the Matrix?
I guess.
Intelligent.
Kind of.
Ish. Inception.
1,000 men. Women and children, all bound
together
by
Naruto. Oh, Japan.
A desire to create a world.
And they were going to use the moon, too. They were going to, like, project the illusion from the moon. What is with the moon?
Well, it's a convenient location. It's a pre-orbiting satellite.
Piccolo and Dragon Ball had the right idea of blowing up the moon.
You have less than an hour.
Fuck the moon.
Okay.
I can't allow you to attend the big purification party, but I'll be down to see you right after.
More like the Republican Party, am I right? And there goes half my subscribers.
You have Republicans watching this show?
I don't know, maybe.
So
I have like 80.
I shouldn't be insulting Trump so much.
Eh.
His offer is tempting.
We've Sounds been like whiny liberals since this channel began, so.
Are there any non, like, I guess, are there any conservative video? I thought conservatives were against video games, so they wouldn't be out.
Oh, no, there's totally people, conservative-minded people in the game industry and in the LP industry.
I thought they were like, oh, no, this is like Satan's tool. I've got to find a
way to stop them. But see, those are the people that, like, say that there's no problem with sexism in gaming or who joined Gamergate.
Maybe it's too late. Okay, let's save the Earth. To
do something. Do we have to?
We sort of do, because our friends are down there.
Quote-unquote friends. I don't know. I looked through the Colonel's probably dead. Overcoat,
but they've taken everything. Okay.
Yeah, he's getting... I don't know. We don't know. He's, like, at the hospital. Could be. Maybe he's dead. Though. At least they didn't find the winter chip. So what happens if we didn't hide it in our watch?
We'd probably lose it and have to restart the whole game. No, I don't know. Probably count as a death. Back on Earth, this thing wouldn't last 10 minutes without getting spray painted. Yeah, probably. Okay, well, we're in a nice arboretum. Let's leave. This must be the way out, and I can hear someone pacing from the other side. Probably fine. The guard. We won't open that door.
Ooh, what's that? And that's a Puffbuster smoke detector. Puffbuster? I like that name.
Puffbuster.
I saw the
trailer for the new Ghostbusters movie. I wasn't overly impressed.
Yeah, like, I didn't hate it or love it, and it was just kind of there.
Yeah, I was like, it didn't strike me as being particularly innovative or funny. It just seems like another typical, you know, movie.
Yeah, it seemed fine, but, like, whatever.
Not funny, but not, like, as original as the original Ghostbusters.
To be honest, I am not crazy about the original to begin with.
Oh, I love the original.
Yeah.
But the original was new and different and, like, unlike anything, and this one is coming across to me as very
derivative,
just normal, just a normal 2000s comedy.
Yeah, I we'll see how it turns out.
I don't feel like it's going to change comedy the way the original Ghostbusters.
Some people are really Ghostbusters change comedy. I don't know.
I mean, because none of those people were big movie stars until they'd all done Saturday Night Live, but they weren't huge movie stars until that came out.
I guess, like, I don't know. Like, maybe I have. Maybe it's because I didn't really grow up liking Ghostbusters. I didn't really watch it until a few years ago.
Oh, it was my favorite TV show when I was a kid. I watched the crap out of that.
I mean, the movie.
The movie, too, but I like. My point is I've always been into
it. But, like, I watched it, and I'm like, okay, I mean, it was okay, I guess, but I think I see my office from up it just kind of seemed like a movie. I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, it is a movie.
I guess it's
not the greatest movie.
I'm just not quite sure why it's considered groundbreaking, I guess.
Yeah, I love this. The Infinite Void. Reminds me of my conversations with Milan Toad. Do you remember her?
Who was her again?
That was that ditzy one.
Girlfriend. Oh.
The Infinite Void.
Yeah.
I have no brain cells.
You mean like the one that banged the plumber?
No, that was his wife.
Oh. A rake. Oh, the other ditzy one. Okay. All the leaves in here.
Take me a rake.
Shove that in the bag of holding.
Yep. Well, I don't have much in my bag of holding anymore now. So I need one more thing.
Okay, I think I can explain why, like, everything distorts when you're walking by it and puffs up. It's because of the smoke, man. It's making everything get all bumpy. And
I don't have smoke. Is there smoke?
No, I mean, like, the lethal poison smoke that makes that the people bumpy. Yeah. It's everywhere, so we're all doomed.
There's a rock I'm looking for.
A rock?
Also an island. No, wait, that's wrong. I can never remember where this POS is. Sitting on top of Summit.
Yeah, as far as movies I'm looking forward to, it's mostly just the Marvel stuff and the Star Wars stuff and
there's a few other things.
The geek stuff.
I'm curious about the new version of the Jungle Book.
I liked Disney a lot growing up, but I was actually never too huge on the Jungle Book. But
it's got a good cast, and it's got Jon Favreau's directing it. So.
Yeah. So yeah, okay, Favreau's directing. Okay. Yeah. And I kind of like Scarlett Johansson as Ka.
As Ka will be pretty awesome.
I thought that was an interesting choice.
I think overall it's a good cast. I think Bill Murray is Baloo.
Oh, okay. Okay.
And Ben Kingsley, it might be Ben Kingsley's either Bagheera or Shere Khan. Yeah.
Disney's been doing this a lot lately, where they're making live action versions of.
Well, they can now with CGI. They could, because there were live action versions of the Jungle Book before, but of course, because it was all done with real animals, the animals didn't do much. It was all humans. Like there was a real
Flint and Stone. Okay.
There was a live action version of the Jungle Book in the 90s that had Jason Scott Lee and Sam Neill and John Cleese in it.
And then there was Jar Jar of the Jungle.
And Cary Elwes was the bad guy. He gets eaten by Ka. It's great. So we're going to put some lighter fluid on this.
Okay.
And then we're going to do this. And this is going to be hilarious.
Just set this bitch on fire?
We're going to get the set off the smoke alarm.
Oh, hello.
That's the security guard.
Kind of looks like John Cena.
Does he?
I don't know. Well, I know John Cena is, maybe. Kind of looks like
how the graphics change when it goes into like, movie mode a little bit from when it's in like interactive mode.
It's like skinny, scrawny John Cena.
Yep.
Sad show, Bob.
It worked. I don't know how I hid behind that column, but that's pretty great.
What an idiot. Oh.
That was unnecessary. Slapstick.
Yeah, there's a lot of slapstick.
Okay, so let's not go back into that room because there's an angry guy in it.
Oh, he's going to wake up eventually. Yeah.
So let's figure out what else is on this floor. We're in a space station now, so that's the thing that happened.
You know, 2020.
What?
That's how it's going to be in 2020.
We might have that super fast train by 2020. That was pretty cool.
So, this is the door to the observatory. Sounds like a place worth looking into.
Or looking out of. Oh. We're kind of dangerously close to those asteroids.
Like following the Moonchild around like big stone puppies.
That's very, very unsafe.
Yes.
We should probably do something about this. So we don't all die.
Everyone's going to die eventually.
The cocktail glass is worthless, but I love flex straws.
Yep, flex straws are pretty great.
Yeah, they are. They really are.
It's practically unbreakable.
Unbreakable.
That's a good use of technology.
Yeah.
For something you're going to throw away after using once.
I know, you can save it, put it in your washing machine.
What a great tree. If I get off this godforsaken pleasure satellite, I'm taking it with me.
Will that fit in your bag of holding?
Probably not, but I can move it.
There's something behind the tree.
This floor panel looks like it's removable.
The straw? Can you actually use the straw?
That would be hilarious, but
I wish.
This looks like an old-fashioned telephone jack. No, it's a recessed button. I'll need something to reach.
Is that what you use the straw for?
That I can use the straw for. I can't remember this bit. I actually can't remember everything about it. Oh, hello. So that's a thing that happened.
I find a lot of games, the later stuff is the stuff you remember the least. Because you'll play it the least.
Yeah.
Like, sometimes you might start a playthrough but not finish it, so then later on you'll start a new playthrough. So you'll see the early stuff multiple times compared to the later stuff.
Exactly, yeah. That's why the early stuff... Locked. Oh, I need a key for that.
Like, you say you've played this game a couple dozen times, but you probably haven't completed it every single time you've started.
I usually do,
right?
It's just that this last bit is pretty quick.
Yeah.
It shortens up as they get to the end. I'm probably running out of disk space.
Yeah.
Okay, so I need to unlock this with a key of some kind, which I don't really...
Oh, man. Some games have had that problem, like, really badly. Have you ever heard of, like, Xenogears on the PS1?
It sounds familiar.
It's a two-disc RPG made by Square. Like, the first disc was, like, really long and involved, and, like, the second disc, they, like, ran out of money. So the second disc is mostly just, like, character, like, just sits in a chair and talks to you and tells you what happened, and then, like, boss battle, and then goes back to different characters sitting in a chair telling you what happens, and then boss battle.
Oh,
and, like, then, like, dungeon. Final dungeon. It's a mess. It's a great game, but, yeah, it, like, really obviously runs out of money.
Qualifies as an emergency.
I can't remember if that'll kill me. I better save.
And I seem to recall they put the remainder of the budget towards Final Fantasy VIII or something.
Oh, which was worth it.
Which is, like, one of the worst the Final Fantasies. Kind of although I didn't find it. ID badge.
Locked.
I don't know. 8 has the misfortune of being in between 7 and 9. Which are both really excellent games, in my opinion. 8 does have an awesome card game minigame, though. It's a collectible card game. You play people all over the world. It's a fun game.
Maybe I'll find Sleeping Beauty in there.
Well.
The stasis room, I feel like I've stepped into a fairy tale. I'm no Prince Charming, but there's a Sleeping Beauty lying peacefully in a cryonic.
Is that going to be our, what's her name?
Boy, do I need to talk to her. As I look around, I spot a console nearby. Looking it over, I figure it must be used to control the cryonic sleep state.
Great.
If I can resuscitate Ava, maybe we can still stop the cult.
Do I really need her?
Consoles like this before.
Can we just leave her?
The four buttons along the top must administer injections. The two slider controls look like they regulate the air temperature and oxygen level inside the cryonic tube. I seem to remember that slider mechanisms like these are really sensitive and need to be moved slowly. Well, first things first, I'll need to turn this thing on.
This seems complicated.
Yeah, unfortunately, it's also super trial and error-y.
Oh, great.
Because that's the way you want things to go.
Don't suppose you remember exactly what to do.
I remember most of it, but we'll see what happens.
As I enter
this, we don't
see. Oh, they make you go through all that again?
Oh, there she is.
Well, hey.
Hey, it's Lilu. Believe we start with the temperature?
Aha. Uh-huh. Oh. A red light went off in one of those phase one boxes. I must have done something right. Now I've got to get those other boxes to light up.
At least there's a convenient hint button there.
Well, that's it. I haven't used any hints yet. I don't really want to start now.
Yeah.
I believe it's adrenaline. Yep. And then the shock. Burp.
Okay.
Then we raise the temperature a little more. Oh, God, I can't believe I still remember most of this.
Well, you said you played this a lot. Yeah, at some point, it just becomes these, muscle memory.
It might be. It's either the adrenaline again or the bicarbonate. Let's try the adrenaline. Crap.
That yellow warning light doesn't look good. Maybe I should wait a few seconds and see if it goes off before I try anything else.
Well, she's fine. Look at her. She's happy. Oh, yeah. She's dancing.
Don't die. Pentothal, then. That's it. And then it's the adrenaline. Yep. And then oxygen.
So is there any way to actually learn what you're supposed to do? Like,
not really. It's just trial and error. Because wow. You're just looking at this console. How would you know, right? Which is a bit of frustrating. Yeah, it'd be cool if there was a way to, like...
Like if it was somewhere else in the base, you could find, like, instructions or something.
Yeah, there's that. And then I believe it is... It's either the adrenaline or the bicarb first. Bicarb? Nope. I think that might kill her. Nope, she's okay. Adrenaline, then. And then the bicarb. That's it.
Okay. That wasn't so bad.
No.
Since you knew what you were doing.
Yeah, first time I did this, it took a few goes.
Yeah, that could have taken a while if you had no idea.
So, is it all over? Are your prophecies taken care of?
Look, prophecies aren't my job description, okay? I'm just a humble PI trying to save the world as we know it.
Well, if you're not in the cult, then what are you doing here?
I just said.
Look, I think we're running out of time here, but my name's Tex Murphy. I know you're Ava Shaughnessy because I followed your trail from the Colonel to GRS to up here. So why don't you tell me how you ended up getting freeze-dried?
Percival has a thing for me, so he decided not to have me killed. Instead, he put me into stasis to keep me out of the way until after the purification.
Well, I've got some good news.
That's
and I've
creepy.
Got some bad news. Yeah. The good news is the purification won't start for about 45 minutes. The bad news is we've only got 45 minutes to stop these people. Luckily, I've got the winter chip, but you need to tell me how to use it.
Well, how did you get it? Listen, there's no time for explanations now.
There's no time.
Yeah.
Take this. There are instructions on what to do with the winter chip. When you get into position, wait for my signal. In exactly 30 minutes, I'm going to create a power surge. That will give us our last chance to stop the cult. That note also has instructions on how to reach the escape pods. I'll wait until the last second, but hurry. And listen, Murphy, good luck. We get out of here, you can tell me your story.
Maybe we can make out or something?
Yeah.
Well, okay. How about we save the world next time on Cruise Control?
Yep, sounds good.
See you guys in a couple days for maybe the conclusion.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
All right, see you in a couple days.
Bye.